Hello, God Life, and Happy New Year. As this year starts, let's seek God together. And I want to share with you a scripture today, Luke chapter 18, verses 1 through 8. And it's a parable, and Jesus shares this story so that we will continue to pray and not give up. That's what I want to tell you today. Keep praying and don't give up. It's not just me saying it, it's Jesus. In Luke chapter 18, we read that Jesus knows. He knows the reality that in prayer, sometimes we want to tap out, give up, and just quit. We get stuck in prayer, but he's here to encourage us. And with prayer, you might be believing some lies. The devil wants you to not pray, not get on your knees, not seek God. And sometimes we feel like I'm not very good at prayer, but prayer's not performance. And then sometimes we feel like I'm so busy, how am I ever going to pray? We need to shift our priorities to pray and seek the Lord. And sometimes it feels like my prayers aren't being answered. I've prayed for over 30 years for some things that are dear and close to my heart, things that I desire so much, but I have not received a yes yet from the Lord and not seen that answer to prayer. But even with that, Jesus says, keep praying. Don't give up, don't give up, don't give up. As we start 2020, let's get on our knees. In our church and in many churches across our country and the world, there's a time of prayer and fasting for the next 3 weeks, seeking the Lord. For me, I'm gonna have less of my phone and less food and more time in prayer and more time in scripture. God answers prayer in amazing ways. When you think about what he does around the world, apartheid has changed, the Berlin Wall's come down, civil rights movement. And then in our generation, what could happen? We've seen in our church, there's over 2,000 kids through partnership with World Vision that now have clean water for life. And we think of all the kids who don't have food and don't have water. There are 2 million people where I live in my city who don't follow Jesus. There are 2 billion people around the world who have not heard the gospel and the good news about Jesus. When we pray and fast, God moves in power. We know we're human. We have limits. We can't do it, but God can. He wants us to enter in with faith, 100% enter in, not 50% or 25%, but pray, continue to pray, believe him, and then act as he leads us in the power of the Holy Spirit. I'm thinking about a prayer that was in the 1500s, John Knox in Scotland. He saw what was happening and he started to pray, give me Scotland or I die. He wanted to see people in Scotland. He wanted to see an awakening in their hearts and in the land. And as he prayed that, there were Christians that were burned on the stake. But he continued to pray, give me Scotland or I die. And what is your one thing that starting this year you are praying for, going to continue to pray for? Give me what or I die? That's a deep level of commitment, passion. Give me Scotland or I die. What's your prayer request? Give me what or I die. For Luke 18, it was the widow who came to the unjust judge and said, give me protection. She continued to pray and protection was granted. How much more with God who hears us, loves us, does he answer prayer? As you pray, I want you to picture the Father, throne of grace, in heaven and on his right hand, Jesus, who is our mediator, intercedes for us, cares for us, prays for us. And then the Holy Spirit. If you put your trust in Jesus, God lives in you. The Holy Spirit is in you. And as we pray in our weakness, Romans chapter 8, the Holy Spirit intercedes for us with groanings, crying out, because sometimes we get stuck in prayer. We don't know what to pray, but the Holy Spirit is helping us. Jesus praying for us. The Father is gracious. Prayer is a relationship. It's not a formula. God is not a vending machine. And he wants us to come authentically, humbly, fervently, and seek him together. Let's pray. What is your prayer request? Put just a note here. Make a comment where you're watching from and what's your prayer request for this year. Let's pray for each other. If you've never put your trust in Jesus, please leave that in the comment that you want to follow the Lord. That's where it starts, a relationship with God. Listen, it begins with receiving. Receive his grace. You don't earn it. It's not through religion and performance. You receive his grace. You have eternal life. You become part of God's family forever. And then every day receive his word, his spirit, his grace, his love, his encouragement, his protection. Receive into your overflowing. And then that'll overflow into your relationships. God wants to fill you with his spirit, empower you and lead you. It begins with prayer. Let's humble ourselves. Let's get on our knees. God will heal our land. God will do amazing things through our prayers. It's for his glory. When we pray and he answers it, we know it's for his glory. And be sure to give him the praise. Thank him for what he's doing. Thank you so much for connecting. I love you. Check out God Life TV for more videos as well. And as we start this year, let's pray, fast, seek Jesus, because it's all about Jesus. And again, leave any comments. You can share this video with other people that need encouragement on prayer. And Jesus says, keep praying, don't give up. I love you, and together, let's follow Jesus.